Dear students, today we will discuss about some more topics in the chapter electric charges. So first of all, we will see which are the topics that we are going to discuss today. First one is the principle of superposition, and next some problems related to superposition of forces. Next we will discuss about electric field, and later on we will discuss about electric field due to multiple charges, and lastly we will discuss about some problems related to electric field. Now we will see what is meant by the principle of superposition of forces. So first of all we will see the definition, and later on we will discuss what is meant by it. So the principle of superposition of forces says that when a number of charges are interacting, the electrostatic force between two charges is not affected by the existence of the other charges, and the total electrostatic force on a charge is the vector sum of all the forces due to other charges. To understand this, it is very simple. For example, if we are dealing with persons, our interaction with the one person will be no doubt will be affected by the presence of other person. If only one person is there, our interaction with that person will be different, and many persons are there, because of the presence of other persons may influence the interaction of our person with the first person. But in the case of charges, if a number of charges are there, and if we are finding the force on two charges, the force on two charges is not affected by the existence of other charges. Whatever may be the charge present, the force on one charge due to another charge will be remaining same. And the net force on any charge will be equal to the vector sum of the forces due to other charges. So now we will, this is a statement, I think it is clear to everyone. Now we will see the diagrammatic representation and its explanation. So here we are considering three charges, Q1, Q2 and Q3, which are at a distance of R1, R2 and R3 from the origin. So between Q2 and Q3, that distance we are writing it as Q2, Q3, and between Q1 and Q3, that distance we are writing it as R1, Q3. So what is the force acting on 1 due to 2? That is represented as F12. The first expression you can see F12, it is given by, according to Coulomb's law, we can write it as 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 divided by R12 square into unit vector R12. So the direction of force already it is shown in the diagram F12. Now we can find what is the force acting on 1 due to 3. So that is given by F13, which is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q3 divided by R13 square into unit vector R13. So now we'll find the total force. So you can see in that diagram total force on force acting on Q1. That is, we are writing it as F1, which is nothing but F12 plus F13. Here we are writing it in bold letters to show that it is a vector. Both are vectors. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 can be taken common. Q1, Q2 divided by R12 square into unit vector R12 plus Q1, Q3 by R13 square into unit vector R13. So this is the case of three charges, and we are finding the force on first charge due to other charges. The same is applicable for any number of charges. So if n number of charges are there, the total force acting on first charge is given by F1 is equal to F12 plus F13 plus etc. plus F1n. Q1 can be taken common, and 1 4 pi epsilon 0 also can be taken common. So we can write it as Q1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 sigma I is equal to 2 to n Qi divided by R1i square into unit vector R1i. So here whenever we are solving the problems related to multiple charges, forces acting on one charge due to many charges. We have to consider the force on that particular charge due to other charges, and the direction of force also to be included. Then we have to find the resultant force on that charge by applying either parallelogram law or triangle law, or you can find the force by resolving the force into components and adding the components in the same direction and cancelling and then finding the resultant. So here direction also very much important, not only the magnitude but direction also to be specified. Now I think it is all of you understood what is meant by principle of superposition of forces. Now we will discuss one problem. 9 millicoulomb and 36 millicoulomb are kept at 3 meter apart, where a charge plus Q should be kept so that net force on Q is zero. So here first of all we can see two charges are there. One charge is 9 millicoulomb and another charge is 36 millicoulomb. What is their separation? It is at a separation of 3 meter. So we are assuming that the charge is kept at some distance x from 9 millicoulomb. Okay. So what is the distance from the charge Q, from the charge 36 millicoulomb to the charge Q? It will be 3 minus x. So we can write force on Q due to 9 millicoulomb will be equal to force on Q due to 36 millicoulomb. Then only net force will be 0. So by using the formula we can write 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 9 into 10 raised to minus 3 by x square. Why it is x? Because that charge Q is at a distance of x from the charge 9 millicoulomb. That should be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q into 36 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 1 by 3 minus x square. Why 3 minus x? Because that charge is at a distance of 3 minus x from 36 millicoulomb by using Coulomb's law and superposition principle. Now Q can be cancelled. The 9 into 10 raised to minus 3. 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 can be cancelled. So what you will get? 3 minus x whole square divided by x square equal to 36 by 9, because 10 raised to minus 3 also can be cancelled. 36 by 9 is nothing but 4. So if you substitute, we will get 3 minus x by x equal to 2. Why? You can find the square root. So we will get 3 minus x by x equal to 2. Or we can write 3 minus x equal to 2x. Or we will get 3x equal to 3 or x equal to 1 meter, which means that plus Q charge should be at a distance of 1 meter from the charge 9 millicoulomb, or in other words we can say it should be at a distance of 2 meter from 36 millicoulomb. Okay, is it clear? Now we will see another problem. Consider three charges Q1, Q2, Q3, each equal to Q at the vertices of an equilateral triangle of side L. What is the force on a charge Q, capital Q, and what is the specialty of that charge? It has the same sign as that of the charge given, placed at the centroid of the triangle. So first of all, we'll see the diagram. So ABC, equilateral triangle, Q1, Q2, Q3, three charges are given. So first of all, you can see that we have to mark the direction of forces on the charge Q which is kept at the centroid. So F1 is the force acting due to Q1, F2 is the force on Q acting due to Q2, and F3 is the force on capital Q due to Q3. So the direction of forces, already it is shown in the diagram, it is clear to everyone I think. Now we can find the force, net force and the resultant force. So given triangle, first we have to do what we have to do. We have to draw a perpendicular to the side BC. So and From that triangle, we can see AD is equal to AC cos 30. Value of cos 30 is root 3 by 2 and AC is L. So, we will get the value of AD as root 3 by 2 L. Now, we know that AO is equal to 2 by 3 AD because it is the O is the centroid. So, we can write AO is equal to 2 by 3 AD, which is nothing but if you substitute the value of AD, we will get it as 1 by root 3 into L. Now, by symmetry, we can say AO is equal to BO is equal to CO, which means the distance from the three charges Q1, Q2 and Q3 to the charge plus Q is same. Now, we can write the expression of force, F force due to first charge F1, that can be written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 capital Q into small q divided by L by root 3 whole square, and that root 3 whole square will come to numerator, that's why we are getting it expression as 3qq by 4 pi epsilon 0 L square along AO. Why it is along AO? Because it is repulsive force. Similarly, we can write F2, same expression, will get it as 3qq by 4 pi epsilon 0 L square along BO. Same way, we can write F3 is equal to 3qq by 4 pi epsilon 0 L square along CO. Direction of forces already shown in the first diagram. You can see F1, F2, F3, all the three forces direction already it is shown in the diagram. Now, what we have to do? We got the forces. Three forces are there. First of all, we have to find the net force. So, we can see F2 and F3. If we consider the forces F2 and F3 and if we are finding the resultant of those two forces, the resultant we will get it same as 3qq by 4 pi epsilon 0 L square, and the direction will be along OA, which is opposite to the direction of forces F1. How we are getting this expression? We are getting this expression by parallelogram law of vectors, by applying parallelogram law, which is if two forces are there, resultant force is given by F is equal to F1 square plus F2 square plus 2 F1 F2 cos theta. If you apply that formula, you can get the resultant of forces. Already angle also given, you can find it. So, one force F1 is acting along AO, that magnitude is given by 3qq by 4 pi epsilon 0 L square, and resultant of F2 and F3 is acting along OA, which is given by again by magnitude, same magnitude, 3qq by 4 pi epsilon 0 L square. So, what will be the net force? Net force will be 0 because both are acting in opposite direction. So, we can say that the net force acting will be 0. So, whenever we are applying superposition principle, two things we have to keep it in mind. First of all, we have to represent the direction of forces. Then we have to find the resultant of those two forces, two or three, whatever may be the forces. So first we can simplify. First we can consider two forces. Then we can find its resultant by using parallelogram law of vectors. So by using that, in that same way, we can simplify and finally we can find the net force and the direction also to be find out by same. So, this is about superposition principle and application. It is clear to everyone, I think. I think so. Any doubt? So, this is very much important. Whenever you are finding the resultant force, you have to specify the direction and magnitude. So, next we will discuss about another topic in another class.